I'm Mana mana. Mana mana. Mana mana.
Hey kids, welcome back to our online lessons. As you know, we have been in this series called the Experiencing the Holy Spirit, and we have been walking through the life and ministry of Peter in the book of Acts. So I just want to take a few minutes this morning and just do a quick check-in. I just want to see how you all are doing. How have you been like Jesus over the last week or two? And I would love to hear sometime, maybe when you're back with us on Sunday morning, just some of the cool stories that God has done in your life during this quarantine time, right? So, just take a few minutes. I just think to yourself how you were like Jesus. And so we're just gonna take and we'll be right back and to just do a quick recap of what we've been talking about over the last couple of weeks. And then we're going to get into our lesson, a really cool story on how as the Holy Spirit worked through Peter and even Peter's shadow. It's a really amazing story, some really cool Holy Spirit stuff. And so can't wait. We'll be right back. Hey kids, welcome back. We're just going to do a quick recap of what we've been talking about over the last several weeks. As you know, we have been in a series called Experiencing the Holy Spirit, and we have just been walking through the life and ministry of Peter, the Apostle Peter. We've been in the story where Peter and John heal a layman, and then things just went crazy after that, right? The Holy Spirit was showing up in people's lives, the religious leaders and rulers that really didn't have a relationship with Jesus were getting mad and arresting Peter and John. And then we see an amazing work of the Holy Spirit. We're seeing people being healed left and right from various sicknesses and the Holy Spirit using Peter. And so, like I said, this morning, we're going to talk about how the Holy Spirit moved through Peter's shadow. We're going to see how people from all over the region were bringing their sick and trying to catch the shadow of Peter. And so, so we're going to dive into this story. And we're just going to learn a lot more about what the Holy Spirit's doing. And did you know, kids, that the Holy Spirit can work just like this through you, right? Just simply praying for your friends, your neighbors. The Holy Spirit wants to show up and do amazing work. Well, we talked about last week the Holy Spirit filled the room and the whole room shook and people were just amazed by what the Holy Spirit was doing. We're going to jump into our next story. As you know, we've been in this series called Experiencing the Holy Spirit. We've been walking through different stories on how the Holy Spirit showed up in amazing ways, and that how the apostles were used by the Holy Spirit to pray for the sick, to see people healed. And we're going to jump in, like I said, into our next story, Acts chapter 5, verses 12 through 16. This is a really cool story because really something really neat happens here. And we're going to talk about that. We're going to see three really cool things happen. So let's read. Let's read from Acts chapter 5, verses 12 through 16. It says, "The apostles performed many miracles, signs, and wonders among the people, and all the believers used to meet together in Solomon's colonnade. No one else dared join them, even though they were highly regarded by the people. Nevertheless, more and more men and women believed in the Lord and were added to their number." We see this again, the church just growing the leaps and bounds. We see people giving their lives over to Jesus because they're seeing what the Holy Spirit is doing. The Holy Spirit is alive, it's active, it's just, it's doing amazing things. In verse 15, it says, "As a result, the people brought the sick into the streets and laid them on beds and mats so that at least Peter's shadow might fall on some of them as he passed by." The crowds gathered also from the towns around Jerusalem, bringing their sick and those tormented by evil spirits, and all of them were healed. I just love this story. We see three really cool things happening. You know, we see first that the apostles were being used by the Holy Spirit to perform signs and wonders, to see miraculous things happen. You see, what we mean by signs and wonders are basically miracles, right? When we see someone get healed either from, you know, maybe cancer to maybe even a broken foot or something, you know, it could be anything that God heals miraculously, right? That is a sign and wonder. We see an example of sign and wonders when Peter and John, we talked about this couple of weeks ago, when Peter and John healed this lame man, right? So when the Holy Spirit, when Jesus healed this lame man, that was a miracle. That was a sign and a wonder. You know, that was a sign that the Holy Spirit was alive and active and powerful. And so we see the apostles really, you know, performing these signs and wonders. Have you all ever seen a miracle? Have you? I know I have. We can look all around us and see different signs and wonders. You know, what was that experience like when you saw, like, maybe a friend miraculously get healed from being sick? What was that response? Was that, I bet that was like, wow, that's amazing, that's crazy. You know, that is really cool. I want some of that, right? The second really cool thing that we see happen was that all the believers gathered together. There was community being formed. You know, people wanted to be with the apostles. People wanted to see what this Holy Spirit was doing, what Jesus was doing. And so they were bringing people from all over Jerusalem just so that they could be around with what God was doing. So if you saw really cool stuff happening, what would you do, right? If you saw God doing amazing things, wouldn't you want to be a part of that? Absolutely. You see, the third really cool thing that was happening here in this story is that people were bringing the sick and the hurting just so that Peter's shadow might fall on him. You see, that's how powerful the Holy Spirit was moving back then. It's like people were just laying their friends who were sick on beds and mats, just that even if Peter walked by them, they were hoping that whatever power that Peter had, which is the Holy Spirit, just might touch their lives through his shadow. Okay, so yeah, so we see the apostles doing really cool miracles. We see a gathering of people coming to know Jesus for the first time, and the church continuing to grow. And then we also see, you know, just the power of this Holy Spirit to where people from around the area, from around Jerusalem, were just, they wanted so much of what was happening, of what Jesus was doing, that they just were bringing them, just laying them on the ground so that Peter's shadow would fall on them. You see, now was it Peter's shadow that did the healing? Well, of course not. It wasn't a shadow that was doing healing. It was the Holy Spirit moving through Peter and using Peter and using Peter's shadow to heal the sick. So do you think that God, the Holy Spirit, can use you too, just like that? Absolutely. So kids, I just want to encourage you that God really wants to use you to pray for the sick, to be used to heal the sick. So we just want to encourage you and to leave you with that. You know, we've had, Riley on about a month and a half ago, and how he shared about a time where God was calling him to be a part of our prayer ministry and to pray for people. Right, there is power when a kid prays for people.
All right, so we're going to take a minute and we're going to transition over to our small group time. But before we do that, I just want to go over our memory verse this week. So kids, I want to encourage you to read this verse, memorize it, kind of soak it in. So it is Acts 5 verses 12. It says, "The apostles performed many signs and wonders among the people, and all the believers used to meet together in Solomon's colonnade." So the piece that I want you to take out of this memory verse is that the apostles were performing many signs and wonders, right? Just like the apostles did, we can do the same thing. We just have to be obedient to Jesus. All right, we'll break up into our small groups. If you're at your home, just feel free to maybe get with a brother or sister or some cousins or some friends, and then we'll be right back. All right. All right, kids, welcome back to our small group discussion time. So I'm just going to take a few minutes and just review what we talked about, review this story in Acts chapter 5, verses 12 through 16. It says that the apostles were performing many signs and wonders, and many people believed in Jesus. People were bringing sick people on beds and mats into the streets just so that Peter's shadow might fall on them as he passed by. Isn't that crazy? Isn't that cool? People were getting healed by Peter's shadow. Now, it's important for us to answer a couple of questions here. The first question is, was there power in the shadow? Were people being healed specifically by the shadow? No. The Holy Spirit was using Peter's shadow to heal the sick. Jesus was using Peter and Peter's shadow to heal the sick. Where did the power from Peter's shadow come from? Well, of course, it came from the Holy Spirit, not the power of the shadow, right? It came from the Holy Spirit. It is important for us to remember that we carry Jesus inside us. Jesus is the answer to every illness, pain, and sin. Therefore, we carry the help people need inside of us. So, here's the last question. How can we use this power to change the world around us? So, kids, I want you to take a few minutes this week, and I want you to think about that question. How can you use the power of the Holy Spirit to change the world around you? All right, so I'm going to pray for us. I'm going to pray us out. Can't wait to see you in person. So, Father, we just come before you. We thank you so much just for example after example in Scripture on how you do amazing things in amazing ways, how you use Peter's shadow to bring healing to the people. Lord, that we know it's not the shadow in itself. It was the power of the Holy Spirit working through Peter, working through Peter's shadow. And people were being so touched by this that they were giving their lives over to you, Lord. Lord, I just ask that we can be a blessing and to those around us, that we can change the world, that you would use us through the power of the Holy Spirit. And so, Father, we love you. In your name I pray. Amen. Amen. All right, looking forward to seeing you all soon. Phenomena. Phenomena. Phenomena.